Hello, all my YouTube followers and fans out there. Back at you with another cooking video. Well, it's been a while since I did videos. I decided to take a sabbatical period. Well, I'm back in full swing with some more great videos. So today's video, we're gonna do a new recipe, a delicious country fried steak with gravy. And we're also gonna have some good steamed broccoli, macaroni and cheese, and who knows what else might pop up on the menu. All right, so I got my flour here mixed together. I put some lemon pepper in there, and I put some garlic powder in there, about 1 1/4 cups of flour. So I'm gonna pour it on my plate here, because I'm gonna coat my steaks in my in the flour. Use this pan here for the eggs. So we got salt here. I'm gonna go ahead and add that in there. Oops. Just add it all in the flour there. All right, so next what I'm going to do is crack my eggs. Need about 3 eggs for this recipe. You're gonna add some milk in here to your eggs. So now that I added those eggs, we're gonna take some beef chuck steak, and then we're gonna first coat these in the egg and then in the flour, and then we're gonna let them set for a few minutes and then re-coat them and go ahead and put them in our skillet. These are cut thin and thin slices. And now you can just pull them together like that. And then what you do is you dip them right in the egg first, like this. And then you take them and put them right in the flour, just like this. And coat them lightly in the flour. Put them on a separate plate, and then we're gonna re-coat them. Do the same thing with this one here. Do the same thing for all of them until you get them all coated. Country Fried Steak dinner is a perfect Sunday dinner. Just drop them in the egg just like that and coat them in the flour. Steaks done and coated and recoated. So now I get a chance to put them in the cast iron skillet. And these only take just minutes to make. They're very easy, very simple. And man, they don't take that long. So we're gonna go ahead and put them in our skillet. We're gonna put about 1/4 of a cup of oil in a cast iron skillet here. I'm gonna turn this on high. Water on the stove here, back here. This here is for my macaroni and cheese. And we're gonna have southern, we're gonna have country style macaroni. What else? The fried steaks and some good broccoli. And oh, I almost forgot. Delicious honey butter biscuits are also on the menu as well. And I can't wait to have some of these. These are good. So I'm going to bake these and have them with our dinner tonight. Let them fry for just a few minutes on each side. And they only take just a few minutes to cook. So you don't want to overcook them. Guys, who wants to overcook steak? Oh, not me. Here you gotta stand by and guard and watch just so they don't burn. So about 3 or 4 minutes on each side will help. And then you just keep checking them and then turn them over. Let those hang out for a little while. Perfect. Looks great. Ah. Come on. Come out of it. Get all these fried up, and then we're gonna start on our macaroni and cheese. Right, for the gravy, we're gonna need 1/4 cup of oil, about 1/4 cup of flour, 3.5 cups of milk, and 2 cups right there. Cool. Grab some more milk. Then I'm going to put 1/2 cup. Salt and freshly ground pepper. So for that gravy, I would love to use some of these yum yums from the pork chops. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. So I'm going to go ahead and pour this oil out so I can do that. I hot. Just the way I need it. Hot, hot, hot. This is going to be our gravy. It's going to go right over our fried pork. Turn this on low heat. And we're going to go ahead and add our flour and oil in there. Because this is going to be the base for our gravy. And I think I'm going to add a little butter in here too. Now we're going to add in our flour. This is going to be the base for the gravy. Add a little gravy fat in there. Water on the back here is coming up to a boil. So we're going to add our noodles up here. Salt. This is going to help flavor the pasta as it cooks. Simply adding a little salt in there. Alright, so now we're going to go ahead and add our milk. Our 3 cups of milk. And this is going to be the gravy here. Let that come together. And let that thicken. The salt and pepper to this here. So I'm gonna let that hang out. And we'll wrap up. All right. Now this gravy is all nice and thick and looking good. It looks just right. I'm going to add a few more seasonings to it, and then after that we'll go ahead and turn it off. And then we'll be all finished. I'm going to add some lemon pepper. Yeah, why not lemon pepper? Ties off everything and makes it delicious. And we're going to add, I guess I'll add some garlic powder. And that's it. Stir that in, and we are done with our gravy. Check on our macaroni here. For the macaroni, I'm gonna do it a different way this time. So I'm gonna add about a cup of milk. I'll just eyeball it. There we go. Should be about a cup. Yeah, that's about a cup. A whole bag of cheese. I'm gonna add another bag too. I want my macaroni cheesy. Some thick cut cheese. We're gonna stir that in there. And we're gonna put this in our air fryer right here and let this air fry. I'm going to have some air fried macaroni and cheese. This is going to be good and tasty. Set this on the back here. No, actually, I'm going to put that right there. Get this out of my way. And some butter. Garlic powder. maybe some hamburger seasoning. Speaking of hamburger, I should do hamburger macaroni and cheese one day. I bet that'd be a good recipe right there. And some black pepper. Oh, yes, lemon pepper. Let's not forget to add that in there. And I think that is it. Turn it on. I turned the heat on so everything can melt together. This is another way you can make macaroni and cheese instead of using flour. But yeah, flour is one way you can do it. Take some butter and lightly butter my pan. Pour a little bit of this in here. This does look good because you taste with your eyes first, right? Oh, yeah. Taste with your eyes. Okay. Place this in our air fryer. And I'm going to let this bake at 340 degrees. For about, I want to say about 20 minutes or 22 minutes, and forget it. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and start on our, steamed broccoli and get those honey biscuits ready. All right, and macaroni is done. Broccoli all ready to go into the steamer. And then we'll go ahead and start on our biscuits. And then we'll be all done. We'll be ready to eat dinner. Alright, so normally when I cut up broccoli, I just do this and break it all into pieces. Just break it all up, or you can just cut in there like this. Put it on medium heat to steam it, and then it'll be nice, delicious, and still green. It won't lose its color while we steam it. All right, now it's time to make those honey butter biscuits. And and all you will need is 3/4 of a cup of water and 1/4 of a cup of butter. You would spread the honey butter on there. So again, that's what you're gonna need for the honey butter mixture to put on top of the biscuits. This is a very easy recipe. Very simple. I'm gonna go ahead and dust my board off. Very simple. All you do is mix them together and then you drop them onto your pan. And we are going to use my air fryer to make them this time. Cups. 3/4 of a cup of water. Here is that package seasoning right here. We're gonna need with the butter. And we'll be all done. Yeah, I told you this is a very simple and easy recipe right here. And these are Red Lobster honey biscuits. Nice to have on the menu. And one of these days I'm gonna have to make some fresh biscuits. I do remember doing a homemade biscuit video years ago. I'll have to do another one. So you just mix that all together. Degrees for about 15 minutes.
just get that done. So now we're gonna take our honey butter sauce. Just pour a little on there, just like that. Now we'll go ahead and finish off our biscuits in our pan. But first I'm gonna grease this a little bit. Right, time to finish them off. Got our broccoli. Here we got our fried steak. Delicious honey butter biscuits. Those look good. It's time to nibble. Delicious macaroni and cheese.